All right, now to a story creating a firestorm in Warren County tonight. A lawyer is comparing the actions of an accused child abuser to Santa Claus.
And this is in reference to the case involving John Hopkins. The former gym teacher is charged with inappropriately touching 28 first grade students. As Tessa DeTiro shows us now, that lawyer is not backing down from those comments.
Good evening, Kyle and Cammie. Parents say the allegations of the interactions their children faced inside gym class here at Clearcreek Elementary are stressful enough, but the thought of these charges being dismissed is very upsetting. The defendant has done nothing more than any Santa Claus would do when a small child sits on their lap. That's the analogy attorney David Chicarelli believes proves his client, John Hopkins, is innocent.
I said that's no difference than a child sitting on a Santa Claus's lap, crying, fighting, screaming, and a Santa Claus will hold the child, move the child around, rub their back, rub their arms to settle them down.
Chicarelli says he has hours worth of video from inside Clearcreek Elementary. He says in it, he can't tell what's criminal and what's chaos.
You're going to see a situation with 40 or 50 or 60 children running around like six-year-olds do, climbing all over the place, falling down and getting hurt, climbing on his lap. There's at times multiple children climbing on him.
The prosecutor's office sent us this statement tonight, standing behind their argument the touching over a span of months inside that locked gym was not innocent.
The doorbell was installed by Mr. Hopkins on the outside of his gym class, and the principal knew about that. The door was locked at all times, from my understanding, and the doorbell would be rung if someone wanted entrance into the gym.
If it were your child, would it make you uncomfortable?
No, I mean, I would have wanted to know the facts.
Chicarelli says videos in court will show none of the contact was for sexual gratification.
I'm not aware of any children that have been emotionally traumatized or anything from this whole situation.
28 families are involved in a separate class action lawsuit against the Springboro Schools. The district will not comment on pending cases. In Springboro, Tessa DeTiro, Local 12 News.
Tessa, thank you. And a judge will hear the motion to dismiss the charges coming up on Tuesday morning.